Joaquin Valley, where Scott and I grew up, stretching 18,000 square miles from Bakersfield to Sacramento. With a rich history of farming and cowboys and Hispanic people, and a rich history of tacos, Scott and I are going to go anywhere and everywhere in the valley to find the best tacos out there.
First place we're heading to is a little town called Orange Cove. It's 96% Hispanic people, farmers, all wearing cowboy hats. And they recommended this place, OC Taco. We're popping in here. It looks pretty authentic to us.
You're a genius in the circle.
Citrus grows everywhere, hence the name Orange Cove. And we're at OC Taco Shop. It's one of the top ranked ones in this tiny little town of like 9,000 or 10,000 people, I think. Anyways, we got some carnitas today. We got one carnitas each, and we got one asada we're gonna try out. So see how it goes. Give this guy a shot. We got the double tortilla. They say they're making their own tortillas here, which looks awesome. That is very good. Very good. Very tender meat. The sauce is a little bit smoky. They got some cabbage kind of cut up in there real fine. That's nice. Meat's really good. God, I can't wait for my next bite. That's good.
The next town was the little town of Orosi. Really cool little place. We really liked it here. Everyone is incredibly friendly. I mean, like, in a good way. Matt found some interesting weird spices and things in this funny grocery store. We also found these dried chilies, an amazing assortment, which was exciting for us. They had New Mexico dried chilies and California dried chilies, so we ended up buying a few of those, of course.
About getting one of these to put in my house for decor, and then I realized that this is for stirring food. This isn't decor. These people are making gigantic pots of beans and food for stirring food. Alright, so no tacos in there, but they did have a ton of cool chilies. We got the New Mexico dried and smoked New Mexico chilies. Scott picked up, Scott picked up some cool hot sauce, La Cajita de Mayor. And you picked up some, what are these called, Scott?
Can't remember.
Not jackfruit,
no.
But another kind of cool fruit they're growing around here, I don't know. And then they got these, they got papaya, a bunch of papaya that they're growing. We said, yeah, we'll take some papaya. And I said, okay. We took it up to the stand, we're paying for it. And the guy goes, hey, do you want us to put the chamoy on it? And,
okay.
The chamoy and the tahine and the lime juice and everything on it? And we were like, yeah, I guess. So he went back there and tossed in some bowl, all this cool stuff. Look, it's pretty amazing. Oh my God. Super sweet papaya with the chili on there.
Mm.
And the, oh man. Savory and sweet, it's almost like meat.
That's the best thing in the world.
Holy moly. So anyway, cool store. There's a couple taco shops down the street we're gonna try to hit. And just enjoying the culture. We're on vacation. This is what they do around here, you know? Also, real quick, I want to add to the video. Scott and I's grandmother
just found out from our dad, we kind of knew, it was somewhere out here, actually graduated from Orosi High School in the 20s, probably around 1920. Graduated from Orosi High School, and then went on, her and her sisters moved on to Fresno State and went to college. So grandma was probably walking right here, probably not eating papaya with chili, but I don't know. Slightly pickled, warm serrano chili. So we squeeze a little bit of the lemon on there. It's kind of the suggested trick. I like to do hot sauce on only half and see what the other half is without the hot sauce. So I usually go first bite with no hot sauce. Okay, two things. It's the best tortilla I've had in a long time. When you order tacos at this place, Tacos Montes, which is a little gem in Orosi we just found, one girl takes your order, the girl next to her grabs the masa, makes it into a bit of a bowl, presses it down, homemade tortilla, takes it off of the press, puts it right on the flat top, and then she starts making your meat ready, and then the tortilla is done, and then puts it together. So the tortilla is like a snowflake. Everyone's different. It's amazing. It's unique. And I'm going to go with the hot sauce on all of them. I'm going to trust them on that. And just hit this up. Oh, man. The second thing is the hot sauce is amazing. It's a little bit vinegary. It's kind of thin. It's amazing. But the meat is not overcooked again. The main thing in carne asada is a lot of places, 50% of the places overcook the meat. These people are making food to order. This is not fast food. There's a town about 5 minutes away. It's called, I'm having a hard time remembering the name. Culver, Colton?
Cutler.
Cutler. It's called Cutler. And there's two spots or three spots that we're supposed to hit there. It's a really small town, but I guess they got some, it's rich in tacos, which most of the Central Valley is, and which is why Scott and I do this this whole thing of filming it, or why we're doing any of this, and go act like we're on vacation in another country, because really, between Bakersfield and Sacramento, California, this Central Valley has probably about 500 towns that have tacos. I mean, we're in a town called Orosi that's got 8,000 people. Cutler's got like 700 people or something, but they got three taco shops that are good. So, but anyways, my point is here to finish out this joint is that no one's going to be better than Tacos Montes here. The homemade tortilla, the salsa that they gave you, the little chili, whatever you want to call it. They don't call it salsa, they call it chili. Everything about that taco was perfect. Scott just said he wants to eat 20 of them, and it was everything you wanted in a taco. We're gonna go to these other places and it'll be fun, but this is probably gonna be the better one. We'll see.
So we drove 1 mile to Cutler. We talked to several locals and they all said go back to Orosi and try the seafood at Restaurant Lago. They didn't do tacos there. So we tried their shrimp tostada, and the locals were right. It was really, really good. From a past that I did not like. When you sit down for the Dinuba is the last stop on the taco tour. The biggest with 22,000 people. We narrowed it down to two. Taco Loco and Tacos Goyo.
Tacos, birria to dip the tacos in, and we got the two barbacoa, the red barbacoa tacos. These suckers are pretty amazing. They're kind of making like a little, getting a corn tortilla. They're putting it on the grill. They're putting, they're drenching it in some enchilada sauce, putting it on the grill, putting cheese down, and then meat, and making like a little quesadilla. And then the trick, what you're supposed to do is dunk it in here. I mean, how slutty is this? Yeah. That is something right there. That is really damn good. I didn't even put the onions and cilantro. Wow. I don't know what this is. God, it's really good though. I don't even know what I'm doing. There's a lot of things.
I guess just eat it.
You dip it in there, you got hot sauce, you got another hot sauce, you got this stuff. Put that in there. Unbelievably good. It's unbelievably good. This helped, whatever this thing is. I'll figure it out in a minute.
What does that taste? That stuff tastes like?
Like a more mild chile, but a bit creamy. I'm not exactly sure what it's doing. I'm gonna try one more thing here by itself. Yeah, it's just a thin chili, but I think maybe the way they emulsified it with oil, it kind of seems like it's creamy, but I think because they blended it and then sort of made like a salad dressing kind of a thing, emulsified oil into it. So, oh man, that's good. That is good. We were in Dinuba. God, every taco is unique. What I love about this whole thing is every single taco is unique. That is fucking amazing. It's different. It's got more of a citrusy, more of an orange. Almost, I'm tasting orange, I think, in the sauce. Chili. Not overcooked again. They're pretty good. These were all top notch to me. And one of the things that stuck out to Scott and I was that all the people were so nice. Especially in Orosi, really friendly people. All the people we spoke to in Orosi, very friendly. They're hospitable. They couldn't believe I was tipping them, and we feel good. And it was just a good day. What a good experience. It's incredible how good these tacos are out here. And so, anyways, thanks for watching. And if you want to hit the subscribe button, hit subscribe and the thumbs up, and we'll go from there. Check into our next videos.